Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, sisters and brothers. Welcome to our 2021 edition of Jazz and Pan Explosion. We want to welcome each one of you and to say thank you for being with us. And we are so happy that we are able to bring this to you in the comfort of your homes. We know the times that we are in and we are unable to get together, but we just have to do this. So we had to find a way. So this evening, I would want to send out condolences to the culture fraternity. We have been losing some of our sisters and brothers. I just want to remind you, in our own Emancipation family, Brother Ifoma Soyinka just passed. We had the passing of Singing Sandra. We had Joker Devines not too long ago, Larry Hayward, and a real tough one, Brother Resistance, and just lately, our latest, Leroy Clark, our phenomenal artist. So to his friends, to their friends and families, We extend our deepest condolences, and we hope that they rest in eternal peace, and hope you too find comfort in the memories that they would have shared with you. So we are bringing the festival to you, and our first segment would be our jazz, and it's jazz in Trinidad and Tobago. Women in Jazz, that is, and we will have a perspective from Sharon Phillips. I hope by now I can say we all know Sharon Phillips. So let's bring on Sharon with a lusty round of applause.
Good afternoon. It's Sharon. Nice to be with you.
Hello, Ms. Jackie. How are you doing? Much.
What can tell you are doing? All right,
yeah. We have to.
Yes. So thank you for agreeing to be part of this discussion.
It's an honor.
Before we get into discussion, I've been reading your bio, and I seen you're here, you're there. One thing that struck me, you're a Bond girl. Seen Bond girls a different so tell me something about Sharon Phillips.
I consider myself to be a pretty normal, very humble. I grew up very humble in the village of Mason Hall, Tobago. I was raised by the entire island of Tobago. I could proudly say that I am one of the byproducts where the entire community of Tobago basically had something to do with my molding and my upbringing. I'm a very proud ambassador of this island, culturally and otherwise. Musically, I've been singing before. I was told I was singing before I could talk properly by my parents. So singing was always the first thing. And basically, when I started, I never stopped. I started singing in church. I started singing in school, and the primary school took me up to the high school took me to the university, and it was from one journey to the next. And at the age of 19, there wasn't very much more for me to do locally, so I left Tobago and became a cultural ambassador in Europe for 16 years.
Great. So, I mean, that might have been really exciting. I could just imagine.
It was a bit scary. I think a lot of people don't understand the sacrifices that creative artists make. Now, when we are at home, in our home island, our home country, we have the buffers of having our families and our friends around to support us. We are in an environment where we know the language fluently so we can communicate. For me, it took a while. Because in order to get your German residence, you have to learn the language. So I was first met with the language barrier, but being a scholastic, it didn't really take me that long to get into the language. And I was like, okay, I have to do this. I have to get the language right in order to stay here. But it was scary because I didn't have any family members there. I didn't have any friends. I was in a completely new environment. And it was a sacrifice I had to make. A lot of people see us on the cameras and they see us on screen and they think it's glamour. But usually what they are seeing is only 15 minutes of 23 hours and 45 minutes of sheer pain and sacrifice.
But you made it, and I'm just so happy that you're glad to be able to share that with us today.
Yes.
So we want to talk women in jazz in Trinidad and Tobago. And yeah. When I talk about women in jazz, people who come to mind for me would be like, so from long ago, Patty Rogers, then we have Mavis John, we have some of the young ones like Ruth Osborne, Vonette Bigford.
Exactly.
Yeah, Shant. We have a lot of women.
Exactly. Maya.
A number of names.
Yeah.
But tell me, from your perspective, what is the situation of women in jazz in Trinidad and Tobago? How they fare? And I know now is a different kind of way they would have to fare, but generally, how they fare?
I would tell you, first of all, before even the pandemic, it's been a challenge. Mm. All right? I think a lot of things are not factored in to what goes into a stellar performance. And I'm talking about from the economic standpoint. There's a lot of other people that hinge on us. There are hairdressers and beauty specialists, makeup artists, there are designers, there are music directors, musicians depend on us in order for them to live as well. And some of our very dedicated citizens are dedicated musicians. Before the pandemic, it was already a challenge with jazz. We have the jazz festival or like a season for jazz, more or less. And after that, basically, it drops off. We have a season for things in the Caribbean, more or less, especially in Trinidad. We have a season where the jazz shows just stack up one behind the next. But in terms of longevity, there's always been the challenge of growing the art form. For me, that has been like a serious problem. Like when I stopped singing jazz, or when I should pass on, and Kay Allen and Vonette Bigford and Maya Scott, when we pass on, then what is the legacy left behind?
There must be some kind of passing the baton. Is there any training for young people in jazz?
On my end here in Tobago, what we do have, we have a problem in the country. My problem that I see is the give back. The notable give back to the youth, the quintessential things that they really need to pivot them forward in the industry are normally not monetarily based. It's a lot of ethics and it's a lot of principles. It's teaching these children that basically this is an innate gift that you have. You may not be able to articulate in another language, but music goes and transcends over that barrier. So in any form, whether it's an instrument or vocally, I've been to places, I've sang in Asia, where I didn't know the language and they didn't know English, but they knew every word of my song. I went to Madrid, Spain, Barcelona, Spain, when Touch Me went number one, and they knew the song in English, but we could not hold a conversation outside of Hola, amigo. That was it. What we lack here is the testicular fortitude from the, first of all, from the artist, and this is something that you're not always going to hear, but we also have to emit a certain level of discipline and persistence towards our craft. It's the respect towards what we do, right? We first must invest in our craft. Our government also needs to see the human resources, our artists, our musicians, our cultural artists as a very important human resource that they should invest in. Because maybe we are sitting here on the Hollywood of the Caribbean and we don't know. Simply because the correct resources to channel that kind of output has never been input in the correct manner into the industries. See, we invest heavily in shows, but where's the education? Where's the base? Where's the foundation for transference? We're talking about jazz, but we have jazz because of discipline, a lot of pain, years of struggle, years of sacrifice, and people refusing to get rid of the augmented ninths and fifths and these kinds of things out of the music, keeping the soul of a people, the culture of a people, the history of a time.
Vocal. But there must be some wins. Could you identify some?
Well, in Tobago right now, I could be proud enough to say that we now have the TPAC company, which is responsible for training and cultural training and performing arts and this kind of stuff. So I'm proud to say I'm very eager to see what Mr. Elvis Rajman and his team has in store for the people of Tobago. But like myself and a lot of other musicians and other artists in the art forms, we have submitted ourselves. He knows that we are willing and we are ready to train as well as to perform.
But is there something equivalent happening in Trinidad?
I am not aware. What I do know is that from time to time, I engage with, the band, that not the musicians that normally play with me. We did something a few years ago where we came to Trinidad for Black History Month, more or less on our own, and we went to several different schools. Okay. We turned our calypso music from Shadow and Sparrow and Calypso Rose and so we turned that into jazz.
Wow.
For Calypso History Month, and we honored the artists who would have gone through that struggle, that Ella Andel and that same singing Sandra and that same, you know, we honored them by turning their calypsos into jazz.
Wow.
So we can actually take our culture anywhere by simply repackaging without changing the actual content of the product.
Mm-hmm. And that's something that amazes me all the time when you hear jazz performances. Somewhere inside there must have a calypso in jazz. It's scattered and all, but it must have some calypso coming to
I'm very cultural based. I must say thanks to the community of Tobago. I mean, I've done everything, drum, belly, everything, just name it, everything in dance, in music, I think I've done. And it was because we have so many festivals here in Tobago. We have the Heritage Festival. We have, you know what I mean? All year, going down the line, we have a lot of things, music festival, Heritage Festival, Carnival, you know. One in every three persons over here has a special musical gift or skill or some creative or performing art or talent that is not yet unleashed.
So tell me, again, we're looking at from your perspective. Mm-hmm. Now that we're in COVID and we cannot do the shows and, you know, we cannot be so lucrative as we would want to be. How exactly are the people, performers in general, but jazz artists in particular, how are you faring?
I personally, I'm doing okay in the terms of, this for us is a very hard blow. We were more looking forward to jazz festival more than Carnival, and we had Carnival, but not jazz festival. But it did take it. People need to understand that we as artists are normal people. And though they see us in a position of, okay, she's holding the mic, she's got on the amazing hairstyle and the amazing designer wear clothes, and she's rocking the stage, which we could do practically in a garbage bag. The reality is we are normal people, and there are a lot of other people behind us who and around us who come before us who need to get paid so that they could take care of their families as well, and their bills as well. They depend on us. When we shut down, although it's not our fault, but we become broken because we are incapable of helping those who are helping us to make a career of ourselves. You know, so a lot of the artists are not doing well. A lot of the musicians are severely frustrated, and there isn't really there isn't really much space for us to vent. Now, people need to understand something. A musician, whether you are playing pan, whether you are playing the drums, whether you are singing, you are playing a clarinet, a flute, it doesn't matter. Musicians are very sensual and sensitive people. When we get on stage, we are doctors and attorneys and at that moment, we are educators and we are nurses and we are everything, practitioners of the heart. We are everything. Someone may have come in there with the idea of committing suicide. It's my job with the microphone to change that reality by the time the song is done. That's a very hard responsibility and an extremely high level of expectation from a person. So you could imagine when we crash on the emotional side very heavy because we are used to giving of the emotional side. A lot of us are not doing so well.
In this time of, it's not post COVID,
it's not going to go anywhere. But whereas we could look at the glass from being half empty, I think if we look at that too long, we may not see that the glass is actually still half full. I think it's also a great time for opportunity. Mm-hmm. It's a time for us to become creative. You see, we've become very stereotyped. And I know a lot of musicians are not going to probably like what I have to say here, but as we recognize, things could change globally just like that. Mm-hmm. So we have got to look at diversification of our own art form. So maybe after performing for so many years, maybe now you can think of tutoring a class. So you're not only depending on a gig to have some money, but now you can establish something where you are transferring a skill, you are changing a reality, you are also generating an income. We've got to change these kinds of aspects. You see Beyonce getting involved in acting. We don't take the downtime to better our skill sets. There are opportunities that need to present, that are going to present themselves. How prepared are we going to be after being down for so long is another question.
Right.
There's a lot of factors to weigh into it.
Yeah. You know, I was about to say that the hospitality and entertainment industry were particularly hard hit by COVID. But I'm hearing what you're saying, and I'm wondering to whether there are sufficient people who could just turn that skill into that other kind of business. You know, I might be able to sing or dance, but can I teach someone to sing or dance? You know, so again, I think mindsets have to be changed.
It's a lot of work,
and people prepared to do it.
We are going to find out. At the end of the day, I can't make the decision for the people of Trinidad and Tobago. What I do know is that fate seldom ever calls on you at a time of your own choosing. So this is the time when, without us choosing to have to show that testicular fortitude, that gumption, that unity, that stick together, that become patriotic enough to do it for free, this is the time to rebuild. And fate is not going to call on us when it's all comfortable, when we're going through an oil boom. Fate is calling on us right now. At the end of the day, we're going to have more than just one lost generation if we stop or if we allow a scenario like this. Remember, our culture is deeply hinged on how we recover. The story of our culture going forward is deeply hinged on how we recover from this. Mm-hmm. What happens if there isn't another carnival for the next 6 years?
Oh, God forbid.
What would happen if there's another? This is what I'm trying to say. So as we never imagined this would happen. We never thought it would last this long. But suppose, and suppose it drags on for a couple more years. We need to start putting contingency plans in place in terms of how we do things going forward. Someone could create, as an artist, I don't try to do everything. Now, I am a jack of all trades, master of a few too. I'm a designer. I like to cook. I like to do a lot of things. I'm a wire vendor. I like to make masks. I play a little pan. You know, I do my things.
Yeah.
I'm a pan mom as well. I'm a pan mom as well. My son and my daughter, amazing panners. The thing is, we've got to stop the idea that we can change it independently. That's not ever going to happen. So we, the people within the fraternity who are the actual practitioners, we're going to need the business specialists to come on board. We're going to need the marketing specialists to come on board and try things they have never tried before. That's not our expertise. Our expertise is to write the songs that make you feel human again. And we don't have the ability to do all of the business. So I'm hoping that what we could get here is some networking and some serious cohesion. We have not really had a music industry in Trinidad and Tobago. Whether it's jazz, whether it's, listen me good. We have a lot of musicians. And we have a lot,
What do you mean by that?
Industry. We have a lot of, we are now forming. The soca industry, I would say, is more or less established. It's huge. Calypso, although I'm very grateful with where we are, I think we can do a lot more, and there's a lot of work to do in terms of lifting the standards there. But we have to stop being event-based. The music industry is a lot more than just you booking me to do a show. There's a lot of legal stuff. Yeah, there's a lot of legal stuff in there. There's merchandising in there. You have a lot of people hinged onto this industry that don't really exist as a unit in this country. I'm asking these people now to get together. Let's have that conversation. Come together. Let's come together and see how much greater we can make this product.
Well, I would say that's a call for action. So let's see after this conversation, who would be reaching out to you or you reaching out to make that happen.
Well, instead of waiting, maybe we should just drop the trump card now, and I'm putting it out there. Anyone who is willing to invest in the youth.
So it starts with one. And then another one.
You wouldn't believe this, but someone changed my life, and you're going to play that in a while. And she didn't even know this was in her absenteeism. She didn't even know, but this one person is an icon to me and a role model, more than just in music, but in life as well. And all she did was change my reality. With her truth, she changed my reality. Now, if by me living my truth, right, because I am recovered from falling into a manhole in 2015 and damaging myself, and I must say thanks to the heavens, I got out of a bad relationship, a bad marriage that I was in for very many years, where I lost myself. And that is why I'm now more motivated going forward. The COVID didn't do well by all of us. Some of us lost relationships. We lost people. People died via the COVID, and we broke. People lost their jobs. People lost their money. People lost a lot of stuff during this COVID. But as long as there is life in us, as long as we draw breath, one thing I know about the women in jazz in this country is that they are a resilient bunch. We know how to get back up.
They're strong.
We know how to get back up. Yes.
Well, I think it's about time then we hear some of your throat.
I am the queen of pesky. Yes.
As you all know that with the COVID, again, we are not able to do face to face. We are not able to come together, but thank God that we have proper archives. We have archival stuff that we can draw on that could put together something so that we can offer our publics. So let's hear some of Sharon of 2019.
I was born by the river. Oh, and just like the river, I've been running ever since. It's been a long, long time coming, but I know change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. I don't know what's waiting for me up there beyond the skies. It's been a long, long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. So I go to the movies and I go downtown. My girlfriends, but they always keep on asking me, Sharon girl, I ain't never ever seeing you around. Cause it's been a long, long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes it will. And then I go to my brother, and I say, brother, help me please. Somehow my brother, he always keeps on knocking me, yeah. Knocking me on my feet. Yeah, well there were times when I wouldn't last for long, but I know God gave me the willpower inside of me to carry on. Cause it's been a brother. Brothers, where you at? And I say, brother, help me please. Yeah. Somehow, the same brother always keeps on knocking me. Knocking me. Change has come. not a young one gone. And you beat your chest and smile, say you's a bad man, and not a young one fall. And now we can't sleep at night, yeah, 'cause you's a bad man. Bad man is a man who does defend woman and protect the young ones by any means, lad. You ain't no bad man, boy. You ain't no bad man. A real bad man knows he don't need a gun. He only needs God. Hey, yeah. You ain't no bad man, boy. You ain't no bad man. So sit down, rock back. Big man, look for a walk. You're too damn evil. Sit down, rock back. Big man, go look for a walk. You're too damn evil. And if you distress my people,
fire go burn them, fire go burn them.
Oh, oh gosh, this is the year of love. Oh,
fire go burn them, fire go burn them.
Oh, oh God, what are you fighting for? The philosophy which hold one race superior ain't another inferior is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned. Every day is why every day is why Trinidad, every day is why tell me what you're fighting for. Fire. We don't no more trouble. Watch the bad man them in your zone and tell them Sharon Phillips says so. We don't need no more trouble. No more, no more, no more, no more, no. We don't need no more trouble, no more trouble. We don't need, tell the bad man that said we don't need, come on, no more trouble. 'Cause yeah, if you distress my people,
fire go burn them, fire go burn them.
Fire go burn them. Oh, oh God, philosophy which holds one race superior and another inferior is finally and permanently disqualified. Baby, and the bell don't every day is war. Bloodshed, no one war. It's blood running on the floor. So tell me what you're fighting for. Fire go burning, fire go burning. Oh, oh God, what are you fighting for? Fire go burning, fire go burning. Oh, oh God, this is the year, this is the year, this is the year. This is the year for love.
I can't lie no more of your darkness. All my pictures sent a fade to black and white. See, I've grown tired. Times that still on the floor. Broken now in the shadows of my life. Now y'all need to understand something. You saved my soul. You saved my soul from falling. Because I love you. You brought me here, and for you I'm gonna shine. Oh, don't let the sun go down on me. Although I made mistakes, I'm still your child, and I'm glad you see.
a performance. Yeah, I tell you, a friend told me, I didn't even know our sound system so good. She going around the savannah and hear this voice fly around and come in the savannah and sit down for the show one day. People up to now, they stop talking about that show. People still talking about that show.
It was magic. It was
Listener, man, and you see that last piece you just saw?
For well, it was playing a few seconds ago, and I don't wear that much makeup, but the tears are there. I haven't seen Mavis Sean and Margaret Gittins for almost a year or thereabout, or probably more. But I could tell you the impact that that woman had in my life. I was going through a very rough time with my mother, and I didn't have a very good relationship growing up with my mom in the first place. And you know, you crave that maternal spirit in the music world. In the music world, I was pivoted locally to jazz because of her, but we never met until I had a show, and then she just showed up at my dressing room, and I almost freaked out, but my manager put everything together and made it happen. And when we came together, I recognized why I gravitated so much towards her music and her personality. She really is that person. She is the mother every daughter or every child wishes that they had. She's a praying woman. She's a woman who is very principle based. She loves love and anything that is lovely and loving. And I met her at a time, and she came into my life at a time when no one else could have saved me. It had to be her. And God made it happen that it was her. And in that moment, what you saw on that show in that night, it was probably one of the lowest emotional spaces I've ever been in.
Ouch.
And all that was left in me was not to murmur and to complain and to think, oh God, why me? Why am I going through these problems? Why am I, happy to? No, I used every last nerve and energy I had at that time. I think I told the people in my life on that night exactly how I felt about them, both Mavis and you, Jackie. You got a special moment too. I remember pulling you up on stage and telling you how much I love you too.
Embarrassing.
It's not ever embarrassing. And you know what happens in jazz, right? Jazz is all about impromptu. It's about what could happen on the spur of the moment. But I'm grateful to have Mavis John. I'm grateful to have known this woman in my life. I'm grateful to have known Mavis John and to have her there at a time when we go through this often. I mean, artists go through this often at a time when I didn't want to sing anymore. I didn't want to. I have several degrees, and I was like, I could just stop now and go into academia. I don't need to put myself through not being able to gig all year because you refuse to be defined as a particular type of artist, having to take lower gages than normal because you don't have that much shows to do, or having to wait long spells in between. I mean, it's a bit different here in Tobago as well. But on the general, I have to thank her. I have so much to thank Mavis John for. I have so much to thank Bonnet Bigfoot for the support from these young cats. I want to say a very special good night to Kay Allen, my baby sister, who I haven't spoken to in a very long time. No fault of either of ours, but she's also a very phenomenal jazz singer as well. I think by now the earth should know about Kay Allen and her vocal range and her prowess. And I'm just honored and grateful to have lived at a time to be one of the people who have made any kind of impact on the jazz world. I'm just honored to be here. I'm learning so much.
Thank you, Lord, for you. So we're coming down to the end. Mm-hmm. And we are ready to say goodnight and for me to say thank you for being a part of this conversation. And any closing words? Any parting words? Any parting words?
I would have a little more than just parting words for you, know what I mean? But to my fellow artists, hold straight. You know, I've never been one to sugarcoat it. It's gonna be tough. It's gonna be like swallowing gravel at times. But one thing it is. When you look at the lifestyle that most of these artists have, they have it because they have a very huge support system. So it's not just them alone crashing at this time. So yeah, it does feel a bit like swallowing gravel from the quarry. But I could guarantee you this much. A diamond would normally look like a rock if it doesn't go through a lot of heat and pressure to purify it. This is our moment to redefine the game. This is our moment to not shift the goalposts, but change the entire playing field. This is the time where we put some emphasis into what we love and make it work. There are a lot of youths out there and a lot of persons. There are a lot of people with a lot of talent that never came forward before because they think that people would shun them because of their social status or because of how they look or because of the demographics of where they might have come from. Let me tell you something. I know about wearing hand-me-downs. I know about sleeping on the floor so that other people could sleep on your bed because your house is the house of refuge. I know about a saucer of food sharing into four. I know about pass the teacup, sip and pass the teacup. I know about go to school with the same bag of bullets for the whole school year. You telling me about the term I'm talking about? Yes. Evo stick, September morning, Evo stick, crazy glue. Last term, after Easter, it's crazy glue to hold it one day till July month. I'm telling you, I know about these things. I know about laying down on the floor in a train station because you don't have money to get to the next destination between shows because a promoter didn't pay you. Or because something negative happened on a show. Now that goes on globally. A lot of us, and I'm not going to be one of those artists who giving people the idea that I've reached and I've arrived. Me reached nowhere. That is how I look at it. We are in an evolving world where we always learning. It doesn't matter. I've sung all over the world, but until I've done it all over the universe, there's absolutely nothing to gloat about. There's enough space here where we can all join together and sing as a choir, so there's no room for competition. Technology will just give us additional mics. What we need to do now is to come together, folks. We need to come together. We need to unite. Those of us who are strong in the industry, those of us who know what's going on and how to deal with certain things, come out and help the younger ones. Come out and help those who can. We shouldn't wait until artists reach the deathbed to go look for them now to pay them some homage or respect, you know, when they're dead, to now be saying how great they were and to now be paying some interest in them. We shouldn't be doing that. And I would make this public now, you know, if you never gave me a stinking Susie while I was alive, my funeral might not be the right place to show up with a wreath because I can't appreciate it then. I love flowers. You could drop them off now while I'm alive and I could appreciate them. So this is what I think we need to do because a lot of artists, I know we're suffering. We have bills, we have producers to pay, we have musicians to pay, we have studios to pay, videos to do, we have designers to see about, we have hairdressers, makeup artists, everybody riding on our back. Not just that, but when you come to the jazz shows, you get a lot of great things to eat. So there's the hospitality and catering section that is also suffering because of a lack of events. And I understand that it's tough for everybody, but we are not alone. And if we band together, I'm thinking that we might be able to help each other a lot more than if we try to do this one by one.
Very good, very good. I'm with you on that. So that's it for the evening.
Well, Miss Jackie, how you feel about our little song?
A little
song.
A cappella.
Normally, when people hear you going to pick up a microphone these days, they don't know if it's auto-tune or passing through some computer front stage. They have no idea. So, you know, I love to hit them the acapella so that they know it's coming from just the diaphragm. It's just between heart and diaphragm.
You have 1 minute. Let me hear you.
All right. I actually want to do something for everyone. And for my mom, who I know is going to be watching this, she's at home. We have a great relationship now. I'm taking care of my mom. She's not in the best of health, but I know she's going to be fine. So for everyone in Trinidad and Tobago at this time, I just want to let you all know. There is no pain that a heart doesn't feel. No one goes alone, not if you walking with me. I'll be your wind in the storms of life. I'll be the boat that you ride through the strife. But if we can love, if we just begin to feel again, we can live again. And if you know how to love, then we for sure will live again. And if you can help your brother or your sister out, yeah, I know. We will live again.
You see, you should have done something. I know, so we could have done a duet.
You would really sing to me, Miss Jackie? You would really sing to me?
Sharon, thank you very much for being with us.
Obrigada.
Until we see you again, just be safe. Take care of your mom.
I will.
It's
going to
be all right.
I will. And I'm hoping that at the very first opportunity, I get to see all my other, you know, compadres in the industry, in the art form. And we get to do some more cool stuff together, because the last cool thing I did was bring, like, the vocals and Pan together with Renegades. And I would like that to go worldwide, so we could take that jazz thing to the rest of the world.
It will happen.
It will.
It will happen. Thanks again, good. Sharon.
Thank you. It's an honor.
Thank you. So we move right into our Pan explosion. And with us, ladies and gentlemen, we have the president of Pan Trinbago with us. You know, August is Pan Month. So let's bring on Madam President Beverly Ramsey Moore. Beverly Ramsey Moore has an unquestionable track record of leadership and service to community and country. She has always been one to champion the cause for equality amongst the less fortunate. Showing up with a tenacity to be successful in these matters, brandishing a supporting track record. She has appeared in various publications such as Caribbean Beat Magazine, Trinidad News Feature, Woman Magazine. Mrs. Ramsey Moore was born into a steel pan family where her father and five of her uncles were founding members of Tobago's oldest plain steel band, Cats and Jammers. She stepped into the role of the manager of the orchestra for the past 14 years, then a little bit of years, you know, 14 years, and has led the group to a number of wins, including the formation of the youth arm of the organization and the development of 3 small businesses. If you ain't have business, you can't survive, because when we can't play pan, we have to do the business on the side. If you were to ask, what one of her greatest accomplishments was, it would be becoming the president of Pan Trinbago after many obstacles. And I could imagine many obstacles for a woman.
Many.
This title has been held by only men before her. She was elected the first female and 17th president of the organization. Mrs. Ramsey Moore has served and continues to provide selfless service on the board of organizations and committees, including Social Welfare Board of Tobago, Ministry of Social Development, Ministry of Tobago Development Grant Funding Committee, Tobago Basketball Zonal Commission, Vice President, BlackRock Government School Board, Tobago Performing Arts, Company Director and Commissioner at the National Carnival Commission. Even though she ensures that she gives of her time on the national scope, she understands that it's critical to give back to the community that raised her. She founded and served as the lead liaison to the BlackRock Youth Organization. She managed the BlackRock basketball and netball teams, served as president of the BlackRock Government School PTA and the secretary of the BlackRock Village Council, taking care of the youth. Volunteering as a community leader catapulted her professional career into the realm of politics and government. That's where I first knew your name, in politics. She was elected to the Tobago House of Assembly for 8 years, where she served as secretary with responsibility for community development and culture, and assistant secretary for youth, sport, and sport in the Tobago House of Assembly. Mrs. Ramsey Moore has been invited to speak at a number of organizations, for example, Tobago Writers Guild Association and the Division of Sport and Youth Affairs, where she spoke on the steel pan development and its impact on communities, her experiences in her professional career, and why she remains committed to her social work. She is the recipient of awards such as Tobago House of Assembly Youth Veteran Award, BlackRock Village Council Award in recognition for outstanding contribution in the field of culture, Tobago Region of Pan Trinbago Achievement Award, Plymouth New Testament Church of God Outstanding Service Award, BlackRock Police Youth Club Award of Excellence, BlackRock Government School Community Icon Award, Cats and Jammers Steel Orchestra Award for committed and dedicated services. Whenever she's asked how she's able to succeed in her role as a wife, mother, and grandmother, and still be passionate about her activism in her community, she responds with, and I'll take note of this quote, failure will never overtake me if my determination to succeed is strong enough. Take that in your pipe and smoke it. So you're from BlackRock?
Yes, I am.
And you're BlackRock. You have to be from BlackRock.
Yes, born and bred.
Very much for your work. I mean, it's phenomenal work that you have done here. And you cross everything. Yes. But I like the work you do with the youth. Seeing that you're not only seeing about them big people, the youth and them featuring prominently in the work that you're doing.
That's right.
So, Miss Ramsey Moore, how are you faring on that executive as a woman president?
I think I'm doing pretty all right, but I'm going to be very honest with you. I think it's a bit challenging for assertive leadership, especially as a female. Mm-hmm. And whilst you know, more and more we have some pushbacks, yeah. But we have three strong women on the executive. But so far in the steel pan world, I have a lot of support from a number, especially the senior men. They see me as their daughter. They are very, very impressed and so on. But I must say that there are some men on the executive who, not the majority though, but I must let you know that they underestimated me. I don't care, as long as I know I am doing the right thing.
Right, exactly.
You know, yes, Franklin exactly. Bego is no longer a feeling trough. And so, you know, you're going to get some pushbacks, but as long as you're doing the right thing, you go and you move, you go straight, you go brave, and that is what I am and what I'm going to do.
And that's all that's needed, you know, doing the right thing. That's all that's needed.
Doing the right thing, yes.
Doing the right thing. So, I just wanted for us to touch a little bit, because we are at Emancipation Support Committee, while we do the Pan Night, which is one of our biggest sellout nights, eh? When is the Pan? I mean, is sweat and jam.
Yes, Pan is community soul. Pan is
everybody
just
comes
out. It's Trinidad and Tobago. As long as you have Pan, you have the nation behind you.
Very well. So we do it for that reason, to recognize the Pan and our contribution to the Pan. But we also use it as the start off of Pan Month. So tell me, what's in store for Pan Month this year? I mean, under this pressurized time.
Yes, this pandemic really has, it's really, really reaping havoc in the entertainment sector. As you know, we depend on large crowds. We, of course, we are live music, and social distance in itself is going to be extremely difficult to hear your popular bands, you know? And so it's as we try to grapple with this pandemic, it has not been easy for us. It's been very challenging. But despite that, despite the challenging times, we are going to move forward. And so we are going to celebrate the 29th year of Pan Month. Since 1992, Pan was declared the musical instrument of Trinidad and Tobago by former Prime Minister Patrick Manning. And ever since, Pan Trinbago has been having activities to mark this symbolic occasion. And so this year we are going to have events. Most of it, of course, will be virtual events. And so we kick off
technology.
That's right. And so we kick off Pan Month on Sunday. And on Sunday we are going to pay tribute to one Ursula Tudor.
Yes,
that's right. Yes, who played with Desperados and has gone home in glory recently. And, you know, we really, really are going to pay tribute to her. May her soul rest in peace. But we were able to give Ursula her roses before she died. Yes. And we had an interview with her. As president, we were able to do that interview earlier this year. And so we are going to be streaming that on our Facebook and Instagram platforms and YouTube in particular, yes. And so that will be on Sunday. We are going to have our church service. It is on the 18th, it is going to be on the 18th. And we are going to have that event. And so we are hoping, no, sorry, it is going to be on the 22nd of August.
Yes.
We are hoping that something is going to happen, but if not, we will find a way to, of course, stream it live. We are going to find a way to do that live. And so we have several events. We are also going to have feature some of our soloists at our verses. So we are going to feature the young panists.
Right.
Particularly those who are in UTT and all of that. And so we are going to give them, and so we have termed the Pan Month, we are going to deal with education, we are going to deal with evolution, We are going to deal with the economics of fun and also entertainment. So it's going to be E-E-E-E. The four E's.
All the E's.
And so we are going to highlight our drum factory, which we have restarted, the drum factory, because you know what has happened. And as I say to our members as we go out there, over the years, of the 50 years of Pan Trinbago, if we are talking development, we should not be standing on one pillar. And we are only standing on one pillar, which is entertainment. And now, because of the pandemic, it's like all over for now. But we have restarted under this new executive, we have restarted the drum factory. So that is what is bringing income in at this time. It is very important that we have cash flow through our businesses. We must be able to put down income generating assets. How can Pantry Bago be 50 years old and not even, you know? And so that is the vision. Our vision at this time is prosperity in Pan. So whilst we know we want to be rich with this gift that has been given to us by our ancestors that God has blessed us with, which is the steel pan, we now must be able to invest so that we can generate income. And so the focus, the other pillar that we want to send down or to stand on is the business aspect of it all. And so we're definitely looking at that. And so we are going to be showing off what is happening at our drum factory. And we are going to involve some of our young tuners. So they're going to show us the works of how we can make a pan from beginning to end and so on. Yes, and that is going to happen. We are also going to be appreciating or showing some appreciation for the sponsors, those who have contributed to all that we have done thus far. And so we are going to bless them. We're going to show some appreciation. All right, we are also going to, we have several events carded. We are going to be on WAP Radio. The young Marcus Ashray will be talking about, he will be doing this, Japan as a tool for community development. So we have that as an educational feature, and Marcus Ashray will be doing that. And then we have Keith Simpson, the vice president, and Keith Simpson, he will be dealing with the evolution. He has the history. Everybody know Keith. Keith is a researcher. And so he has all that information. And so we have several things. And then we have a talent show. The president will be performing. I'll be doing Kaiso. I'll be singing a calypso, you know? Oh, yeah, I could be singing, you know, right? We have several things started. We are going to have an international night where we are going to feature some of our main artists so that we can invite the world at large to participate. And so Pan Month will be an educational month, as I said before. It is going to be very entertaining. We have a number of things, you know, because August is really a special month for you and a special month for us, because we know that Pan, the rhythm of the drums, and we know the history about the banning of the drums and all of that. And we know that this is a very important month as we celebrate emancipation and know where Pan was birthed and where it came from. And all of that, I think it is worth celebrating. Yeah?
Of course. Well, I really look forward. I hope your marketing section is good in throwing out all those advertisements, because we have to know when those things are happening.
Yes.
If I miss one, I will be very vexed.
Yes, all the events, all of that will be out there. We are going to be having a press conference. We will be also going live on Facebook on Saturday, where we will definitely be giving the information. So we have our marketing and promotion team working assiduously. And so the information will be
there. I'm sure I was just being miserable saying that. Of course, they would be doing. So that's Pan Month, and we have some pan here we call Pan Explosion that we want to get into now. And I would like to introduce the Renegades Youth Orchestra. If you could just, I think Pan in good hands, right?
Yes, Pan is in good hands. Our young people are involved.
Young people, listen,
that's right.
They amaze me when I see them going through this. And some of them so, but Pan in good hands. So yes. Let's see them. Renegades Youth Orchestra, if you can bring that up.
Thank you.
well enjoying yourself.
That's right.
Oh, gosh. It is so good to see the young people really taking a keen interest in the pan. And it's so unfortunate again with this lockdown that because they would have a whole day for themselves.
That's right.
Pan come in, and in the day, you have the young people from the different schools and so coming to play the pan. It's always a beautiful sight.
Yeah.
So, we enter pan explosion, and coming up would be Cuba Joylanders. What's your relationship with Cuba Joylanders?
Excellent. Cuba Joylanders is the national medium band champion, and of course they are reigning for 2 years because there was no panorama this year. So they're 2020 and 2021. What I love about Cuba Joylanders is the youth, the energy. You know, youth is a springtime of life. And that band has been the leadership. You know, I saw when we took the medium band panorama to Tobago for the very first time, the finals, they came and they were so focused. Mm-hmm. You know, they are definitely the band of young people that are like, you know, their leaders are youth mentors. Mm-hmm. And the Captain Richard, he is a part of our events committee, and I mean, we are so happy to have the talent. I am so proud of those young people. Yeah. And so having Cuba Joylanders on tonight, I mean, that's amazing. Cuba, imagine they're from Cuba. And they are so good. They practice. I admire that band, and I really bless them up. They're really good.
You see that you talk about being focused. I mean, that's one of the bands that really that what struck me about them at all times is you don't find their pan men wandering, and you have to look for them when coming up. They're right behind the pan, they're ready. Once you say go, they're ready to go.
That's right. And we have a number of bands of a lot of young people, because the young people are the ones who are really carrying the music at this time.
Oh,
and sense. I mean, but they stand out. I'm really, really, you know, proud of the administrators of that orchestra. And when you see them, I mean, they really a beacon of hope, and they make us extremely proud. That's right.
So let's take in a little bit of Cuba Joylanders.
Thank you.
yes.
Yes. Wow.
And that
music
a real turning point, yeah.
Yes.
Cooper Joylanders, ladies and gentlemen. And coming up, we have in Winners Row a couple times.
Who is that? Which one is that? Wow.
From behind the bridge.
One of the big guns.
One of the big ones. You see, we're going up in kind of stages, right? One of the big ones. My band, I'm proud to say. Trinidad. Wow. All stars. Mm. I hope it's your band too.
All the bands are my bands, eh? Okay. You wouldn't want me to be president again.
I want to put you in trouble. Trinidad all stars, ladies and gentlemen, let's enjoy.
We'll be right back.
maybe see people burn down.
Wow, wow. We jamming still, but not
now. Jamming still, the city could burn down.
But COVID-19? We can't jam.
With COVID, we have to stick with time.
So we have the music. We have the music. We have it recorded so we can jam in our homes. You know?
Nothing, these things could be preserved.
That's
and
right.
Just pull it out again.
From that's the archives. Good. Yes. We just get in there and get the music. And that is what we are going to be doing for Pan Month. You know? Wow. I really miss the Panyard. I miss the Panyard. I miss the energy. Mm-hmm. Panny spirit, you know? We miss it. We really, really miss it. But this too shall pass.
Yep, and we'll be better for it.
Yes, definitely.
So we're going into another big gun.
A big gun?
All the way from Tobago. Tell me a little about Cats and Jammers. 14 Ooh. Years you're managing them. Your father, your uncle, your whoever was part of the band. Founding members.
Formed since 1951. Formed. Yeah, so they're celebrating 70 years this year. Yes. Celebrating 70 years and going strong. Cats and Jammers is an institution, you know. Mm. We are so proud of that band, and we, of course, we impact on youth development. We impact seriously on youth development, because you see, your vision, and most times is the direction of your leadership, you know. Mm. You chart the course of the organization, and so far, Cats and Jammers has had a number of dynamic leaders, and now our focus is on using PAN as a vehicle for the development of our young people. And I am so proud of that institution at this time that I lead. And it is not only, well, of course, we enter competitions and we use PAN, and we train our young people to develop social skills and to assist them, you know, in their education and all that, because we say to them, especially our stateside youth members, if you can retain 25 stateside songs, why can't you do well at school? And so we inspire them to excel in their schoolwork. And so we have a really dynamic bunch. We really, really are pleased in the direction. We are focused on business. We have three businesses in terms of what we operate at the Panyard itself. The only thing is that those businesses drive entertainment, drive the businesses. So the food and the bar and the gift shop, and so we have Pan Tourism. We focus a lot. We are in the tourism belt, Black Rock, Turtle Beach, Grafton, Mount Irvine Bay Hotel. So we are in that belt, and so we focus a lot on that. But at this time, Even though those three businesses are not up and running because the Panyard is closed, we have two buses and a truck that we are bringing in a little revenue for us at this time. So that is the direction. That's right. That is what is bringing in the revenue for us at this time. And so that is what we are focusing on. But the music makes us, you know, Cats and Jammers is the pride of Black Rock Tobago. Pan is community soul. We say it all the time. And you say Cats and Jammers, you say Black Rock. It's community pride. And so that is what we want. And it happens here in Trinidad as we talk about the big ones. Pan is Trinidad. Pan is Trinidad. Pan is Tobago. Pan is we. You know?
And I think if each community and each band in a community take that young people, molding of the young people, take that on, we don't have the kind of crime and the kind of
not at all
thing that sometimes happen, because entertainment and culture could really sustain the community and, you know, bring in
and that is why we have to change the direction. Whilst we know that Panorama is what we, you know, is a big event, you know, it's a World Cup event. It's that we need to shift the paradigm. We need to change direction. We need to get into the industry of PAN. We need to develop all of that. We have over 12 acres of land. We have to set up our steel pan industry, you know, industrialization. We need to generate employment. We too need to be drivers of the economy. Pan impacts on everyone. You know, when you go into a pan yard is like a village. It's intergenerational. It's not only the young people, but the young people, the parents are coming in, the grandparents coming in, auntie, nene, and tante, you know, everybody's there. There is so much that can happen. It's an institution.
But what we need to learn from one another
is the leadership that can create that kind of energy. And so that is why we are talking prosperity in Pan. We want to be prosperity financially and also social prosperity, where we can develop our human capital using Pan as a vehicle for social transformation. It is what it does. This is big business. Pan is big business. But unless you have the leadership to take you there, then you are going to be jaws of water and hewers of wood. And we are saying, no longer shall we be in that state.
But I hear you call 12 acres just now. I don't want to touch a sore point, but you're talking about 12 acres, Cats and Jama have or
Jones City? No. Pan Trinbago, I'm talking about. Pan Trinbago. Right. Very correct. And so that is the direction. So I was just making the comparison and trying to draw the nexus of the kind of leadership coming out of Cats and Jamas that I can use to transform. The possibilities that I can use, the skills and the knowledge to transform this God-given Pan Trinbago into the organization and to the beacon of hope that it can be for all our panists and for all our community steel band organizations out there.
Sister, offering love and light for you to do it.
Yes.
Let it be under your watch. Yes. So we're going to hear Cats and Jamas now. So I think it's a 2014 rendition.
Yes.
Our tech people, let's hear Cats and Jamas coming out of Black Rock, Tobago.
We'll be right back.
energy and showmanship.
Sweetness. Wow.
Look at them. And everybody looking like somebody.
One of these days we will be spanking again. We will be spanking again. Hold on, my brothers and sisters. We will be spanking again.
Yes, it will be good to get back into the panniers.
Yes, definitely.
So, Miss Ramsimo, we have come to the end of our time together.
Wow.
And I want to really, really thank you for sharing this time. I want to thank
you. I want to thank you and all those wonderful ladies for the support. I want to, Jackie, you're persistent, you know. I'm glad that you don't give up. We don't give up.
You know, I went through about 10 people to find you. But the number I had for you and work, I'm not getting through. So I check everybody else I know.
And then when you were calling me, and then I'm saying, who is this person trying to reach me? I don't know this young man. I'm saying, I don't know this young man.
So yeah, I said my call. So I just want to repeat here. Failure will never overtake me if my determination to succeed is strong enough.
That's right. That's always, you can win. You can win. And if you don't win, then you learn, you know, lessons learned. So that's
Yeah. It's never a failure.
Never failure.
So thanks again.
Thanks a lot. Happy Emancipation.
I wish you all success. Success with Pan Month. I look forward to hearing when those things are happening so that we can take part, so that we can be a part of it. Mm-hmm.
And so we look forward to continuing working together and to bonding, and that is very important. We are strong women, and we can only be stronger together.
We are now connected, so we know how to reach each other.
That's right.
Right. So ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the end of Jazz and Pan, and I want to thank you for staying with us. I want to also thank the Ministry of Tourism, Culture and the Arts and NLCB for supporting us in this venture. Good night, be safe, and continue observing all the protocols to keep yourselves healthy. Good night.